Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. This is lecture number 17. We are going to discuss the Rayleigh flow part 2. So in the earlier lecture, we defined the Rayleigh flow. We explained the Rayleigh curve, which is the basic curve on which the Rayleigh process is executed, and we calculated the pressure and temperature variation in the Rayleigh flow for both subsonic and supersonic flow conditions. And we continue the property calculation in this lecture. We calculate the remaining property variation in the Rayleigh flow, and we calculate the maximum heat transfer in the Rayleigh flow. The learning outcome to the students: at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to calculate the Rayleigh properties in the Rayleigh flow and determine the maximum heat transfer in Rayleigh flow. The next property is density. Earlier we discussed the pressure variation and temperature variation, and now the property variation is density ratio. So from the ideal gas equation, we may write rho 1 by rho 2 equal to P1 by P2 into T2 by T1. So from the earlier lectures, we substitute for P2 by P1 and T2 by T1, and simplifying, we will get rho 1 by rho 2 equal to M2 square by M1 square into 1 plus gamma M1 square divided by 1 plus gamma M2 square. Now for soaking at the outlet of the duct, we substitute M2 equal to 1 and rho 2 equal to rho star. When the M2 equal to 1, the rho 2 will become choking density at the choking point. So the above equation is reduced to rho by rho star equal to 1 plus gamma M square divided by M square into 1 plus gamma. So substituting M2 equal to 1 here in this equation, we will get the second equation, rho by rho star equal to 1 plus gamma M square divided by M square into 1 plus gamma. And the plotting the variation for gamma equal to 1.4 for various Mach number, rho by rho star, the density ratio is plotted here. The line is the line indicates the equation, which is the representation of density variation with respect to Mach number, and here gamma equal to 1.4. The next ratio property is velocity ratio. From the continuity equation, velocity ratio C2 by C1 equal to rho 1 by rho 2. Rho 1 by rho 2 earlier we discussed. So this is M2 square by M1 square into 1 plus gamma M1 square divided by 1 plus gamma M2 square. Now for the choking condition of the duct, we substitute here M1 equal to 1. So C1 becomes C star. So the above equation is reduced to C by C star equal to M square. M1 here, we take any one of the Mach number into the choking condition. We substitute any one of the Mach number into 1 as 1. So the corresponding velocity will become the choking velocity. So C by C star equal to M square into 1 plus gamma divided by 1 plus gamma M square. So this is how the velocity is changing with respect to the Mach number for gamma equal to 1.4. Then the stagnation pressure ratio, next property is stagnation pressure ratio. The stagnation pressure ratio is given by PO1 by PO2 equal to PO1 by P1 into P1 by P2 plus P2 by PO1. So PO1 by P1 is the stagnation to static pressure ratio of the inlet. P1 by P2 is the pressure ratio for the Rayleigh flow. P2 by PO2 equal to static to stagnation pressure ratio at the outlet. So substituting the three values, so PO1 by P1, P1 by P2 and P2 by PO2, we will get PO1 by PO2 equal to 1 plus gamma M2 square divided by 1 plus gamma M1 square multiplied by 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M1 square divided by 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M2 square into gamma by gamma to the power gamma by gamma minus 1. And this equation for choking condition, here we can reduce the equation M2 equal to 1. So PO2 become PO star. So the equation is reduced to PO by PO star equal to 1 plus gamma divided by 1 plus gamma M square multiplied by 2 by gamma plus 1 into 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M square whole to the power 2 gamma by gamma minus 1. So this equation we may plot here in the equation in the graph. So the stagnation pressure ratio PO by PO star. PO is the any stagnation pressure for given Mach number, and PO star is the stagnation pressure for the choking condition where M equal to 1. For different Mach number, we have the PO by PO star. So in this graph, the gamma value equal to 1.4. Then we calculate the stagnation temperature ratio. The stagnation temperature ratio is given by TO1 by TO2 equal to TO1 by T1 into T1 by T2 plus into T2 by TO2. Where TO1 by T1 is the ratio of stagnation to static temperature at inlet. T1 by T2 is the temperature ratio, static temperature ratio for the Rayleigh flow. T2 by TO2 equal to static to stagnation temperature ratio at the outlet of the flow. Substituting all the values and simplifying, TO1 by TO2 equal to M1 square by M2 square into 1 plus gamma M2 square divided by 1 plus gamma M1 square multiplied by 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M1 square divided by 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M2 square. And for choking at the outlet of the duct, we take M2 equal to 1. So the corresponding temperature TO2 will become TO star. Choking, stagnation, temperature. So the above equation is reduced to TO by TO star equal to 2 M square by gamma plus 1 into 1 plus gamma divided by 1 plus gamma M square multiplied by 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M square. And this equation is plotted in the graph for different Mach number. So the stagnation temperature ratio with respect to Mach number is plotted here for gamma equal to 1.4. So the curve shows the represents the equation. So this is how the stagnation temperature is varying for the subsonic and the supersonic flow in the Rayleigh flow. Then the variation of specific entropy across the in the Rayleigh flow. From thermodynamics, the change in its specific entropy is given by S2 minus S1 equal to Cp into logarithmic of T2 by T1 minus R into logarithmic of P2 by P1. Now you substitute the value T2 by T1 and P2 by P1 and R equal to Cp into gamma minus 1 by gamma, and then simplifying we will get S2 minus S1 divided by Cp equal to logarithmic of M2 square by M1 square into 1 plus gamma M1 square divided by 1 plus gamma M2 square to the power gamma by gamma minus 1. And for choking at the outlet of the duct, we take M2 equal to 1 and the entropy, specific entropy S2 will become S star. S star is the choking, specific entropy at the choking condition. So the above equation is reduced to S minus S star divided by Cp equal to logarithmic of M square into 1 plus gamma divided by 1 plus gamma M square to the power gamma by gamma minus 1. So the change in entropy is plotted here with respect to Mach number for gamma equal to 1.4 and the curve shows represents the equation. And we calculate the maximum heat transfer in the Rayleigh flow. The amount of heat transfer between inlet and the exit condition of the duct is given by Q equal to Cp into TO2 minus T1. Cp into TO2 minus TO1. Now taking the Cp T1 left side. So actually you take the Cp to the left side, Q by Cp divide by T1. So in the similar fashion, we take the other side, TO1 outside and divide by T1. So this become TO1 by T1 into TO2 by T01 minus TO2 by TO1 minus 1. So we are taking Cp to the left side. So Q by Cp divided by T1. So on the other side also divide by T1 and take TO1 to the outside. So TO1 by T1 into TO2 by TO1 minus 1. Now substitute the value of TO1 by T1 and TO2 by TO1 in the equation. TO1 by T1 is the stagnation to static temperature ratio for the entry of the duct, and TO2 by TO1 is the stagnation temperature ratio for the Rayleigh flow. And simplifying, Q by Cp into T1 equal to 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M1 square multiplied by 1 plus gamma minus 1, 1 plus gamma into M1 square divided by 1 plus gamma into M2 square whole to the power 2, M2 square by M1 square whole square into 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M2 square divided by 1 plus gamma minus 1 by 2 M1 square minus 1. So this is the ratio Q by Cp into T1. Now for any inlet condition, subsonic or the supersonic, the maximum heat transfer will be achieved when the exit Mach number reaches unity, that is choking condition. So for exit Mach number, the maximum possible heat transfer can be calculated by substituting M2 equal to 1 in the above equation and simplifying. So, Q max by Cp into T1 equal to 1 minus M1 square whole square divided by 2 into 1 plus gamma into M1 square. So, this is the maximum possible heat transfer in the Rayleigh flow. So, all the equations, whatever we discussed in the presentation, everything is available in the gas tables the book is permitted in the examination, so you do not worry about the equations. Equations are very much available, and during the solving the problem, we are going to refer to the gas tables. So the equations are available, and the table property, we can take the properties from the table for Rayleigh flow from table number 8.1, 8.2 and 8.3. For gamma equal to 1.3, gamma equal to 1.4 and gamma equal to 1.67 respectively, and we solve the unknown value, we determine the unknown value. So the equations and the properties, everything is available in the gas tables book, SM Yahya. We have to understand what is Rayleigh flow, we have to refer to the table and pick up the corresponding equation and calculate the properties, equations and the properties, and solve the unknown, solve for the unknown, that is what the 2T. And this is the sample table, gamma equal to 1.4. So these are all the properties available for gamma equal to, m equal to 0.02 to 10, p by p star, p o by p o star, t by t star, t o by t o star, c by c star equal to rho star by rho, all these values are available from the table. So we have to take the values and we have to calculate the unknown value. Right? So, the unknown value or the amount of heat transfer, everything we have to calculate. And this table shows the effect of heat transfer on the flow properties, particularly in the Rayleigh flow. The flow properties are Mach number, stagnation temperature, stagnation pressure, static pressure, velocity and static temperature. There are two flow conditions. One is subsonic flow, Mach number is less than 1. Supersonic flow, Mach number greater than 1. There are two processes, heating and the cooling process. For heating in the subsonic condition, Mach number increases, stagnation temperature increases, stagnation pressure decreases, static pressure decreases, velocity increases, temperature increases for m is less than 1 by gamma and it decreases for m is greater than 1 by gamma. Similarly, for cooling process, Mach number decreases, stagnation temperature decreases, stagnation pressure increases, static pressure increases, velocity decreases and temperature, static temperature decreases for m is less than 1 by gamma and increases for m is greater than 1 by gamma. Similarly, for the supersonic flow where m is greater than 1 for heating in supersonic conditions, Mach number decreases, stagnation temperature increases, stagnation pressure decreases, static pressure increases, velocity decreases, temperature increases, and for cooling in the supersonic condition, Mach number increases, stagnation temperature decreases, stagnation pressure increases, static pressure decreases, velocity increases and temperature decreases. So this is the, actually whatever we plotted in the form of graph that is being consolidated here, this you have to remember, to some extent you have to remember, or by solving the problem we can understand, numerically we can understand that how the properties are changing for the subsonic or the supersonic flow, either the heating or the cooling process. So we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You may find the gas dynamics and jet propulsion book. You may refer to the book for additional information with respect to the derivation or the graph. And the numerical problems, many number of numerical problems are also solved in the book. In the next lecture, we may solve problems in the Rayleigh flow. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the video lectures for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can write to my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again with the numerical problem solving in the Rayleigh flow in the next lecture.